Nice cock.
Nice cock.
Nice cock. Perfect.
Okay, I like cool. That. Good intro.
Yeah.
What are we doing today? What are we doing today?
We're going to rank, essentially we're going to rank Australian culture.
One of the best and oldest cultures in the world.
Many have said this. People are saying this. Yeah. I imagine, knowing us, that we will agree on a lot of things. However, the things we disagree on, I think typically we get pretty heated about. We get pretty defensive. Neither of us change our stance.
We've been known to engage in some verbal jousting.
Mm. Physical abuse, you know, verbal abuse. It's all, you know, the same. The first one that I found here, and I think this is a good starter because it sets a good tone for the kind of people we are and what we have strong opinions about. Let me just switch to my screen here. So this first one, we're ranking Australian bottlers.
Alright, okay.
Now, fortunately, this one only goes from S to D tier. I didn't make these lists, I just found them on the website.
Alright, look, that's fine. I mean, there's some definite S tier ones just straight straight off the bat.
Oh, off rip, Dan Murphy's S tier.
Oh, I don't know, I think Dan Murphy's A tier, to be honest.
Only A?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Okay, well, all right.
Okay, well, this is not how I expected this to start.
Let's get into it.
Interesting. I think just it's got such a range. It's cheap. You know, the staff there, as you and I both know from when we lived very close to a Dan Murphy's, S tier.
Okay, S tier. Right.
Very few people who understand where all we're going with that.
Alexandria Dan Murphy's, absolutely S plus.
Yes, S plus.
Dan Murphy's in general, I think A tier. Just,
why?
I don't know why.
What knocks it down from an S tier for you?
It's too big.
Why? What do you mean it's too big? You have too many options to buy alcohol?
Yeah, it hasn't got that nice, like, you know, small local bottle shop type,
But you're not going there. You're not going to Woolworths and expecting a local vibe.
Exactly. I hate Woolworths. Like, don't even get me started on the unethical duopoly that Coles and Woolworths hold over groceries.
And how you're single-handedly taking them down with legal, I'm winking into the camera, tactics. Mm.
It's corporate espionage. But,
yeah,
you know,
obviously. You're paid off by IGA, right?
Aldi, actually.
Oh, damn, even worse.
I'm a Swedish plant?
I think they're German.
German? Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, look, I will agree to disagree on this one. We can put it in A tier. I'll allow it. Right. BWS, what are your initial thoughts?
Like, D?
D? I was gonna say they named it what their ranking is, B.
Really? Okay. I was thinking C tier, mostly just because it's, like, pretty expensive and, like...
It is.
Not, like, they quite often close, like, a lot earlier than they're legally allowed to, which I don't like.
Yeah, which, as a grown adult that we are, is a real big problem for us.
I think... The only thing stopping it from being D tier for me is that sometimes they have very good deals.
True. I gotta respect right now. I'm just gonna say hashtag ad here. I got a BWS gift card in my hand, just showing the camera. A $50 BWS gift card. Now this is worth its weight in gold.
$50?
Yep. Right there. So Lord. I gotta put it in B tier purely because I can get a $50 discount.
Unbelievable.
I'm putting a B tier. I'm doing it. Aldi.
Aren't you currently doing a not drinking
correct
thing?
Yep, I'm currently 4 weeks into my 6 weeks of not drinking, which is why that voucher is unused.
Unbelievable. Alright, what's next? Oh, Aldi.
Aldi. S-tier. Yeah, okay. S-tier, we're on the same page here. Storm, 100%. Dog shit beer. Absolutely horrific. But my god, the price to liquid volume.
You can't beat the price to liquid volume ratio.
I think that's what we should have been ranking all of these on, is price to liquid volume ratio.
Yeah, honestly, in that case, it would just be Aldi S tier, everyone else C or D.
Yeah, like, true.
If Aldi's the benchmark, everywhere else sucks.
They're falling down. They're falling down. All right, we're looking at the Bottle-O here. I'm mid.
Yeah, like I think I've only really stepped into a Bottle-O like a couple times, and it'll be because I'm sort of a bit, you know, a bit out of the city limits. I feel like they're only in like I don't want to sound like elitist, but like kind of sketchy areas, like near my dad's place, like yeah, Western Sydney. A lot of
the yeah, Bottle-O. Doctor Dad, tell everyone his exact address and where his local Bottle-O is.
I mean, I don't think he has a local Bottle-O being Muslim and all. But,
true,
you know.
True. Look, I think on top of everything you've said is 100% correct. I think on top of that, the Bottle-O in Australia, marketing-wise, they've hit the jackpot. We all call every liquor shop the Bottle-O, and yet they have still managed to fumble the bag so badly that no one shops there. It's a D-tier marketing alone.
Yeah, like what... I don't know. What are they known for? Being
known for everyone calling every other shop their name and going to shop at every other shop. That's what they're known for.
Just trash.
Yeah, trash. D tier. If there was lower than D tier, it would be in there.
Also, their mixers, like, insanely expensive. You want a bottle of Coke, $1.25, $6.
Oh, that's... You're pulling that number for real? You calling them out right now?
Yeah, miss me with that. Whoa.
Damn, that's...
No.
That I'd miss you with that as well. That's pricey. Next we got First Choice Liquor Market. I don't know if I've ever shopped at one of these.
This is actually my second local. It's my second closest to my house.
Are we saying it's a Victorian specialty?
Maybe. I don't know. Like I've been there once. It was fine. It was very BWS-esque, but a bit bigger. Yeah. I wouldn't say it's A tier.
You wouldn't say it's better than BWS. You'd just say maybe like a low B.
If I had like the choice between the two, I'd probably just pick whichever one was larger.
What's their loyalty program like?
No idea. Been there once.
All right, it's a C tier. I'm putting C tier then.
Okay.
All right. Low. I assume this it cuts off here, but I assume it's any local bottle shop with the town name in it, e.g. Coolangatta Bottle Shop.
I think S.
Yeah, I think their prices never good. It's always overpriced, but the people in there, insane.
Yeah, S-tier. That's the kind of place where like you might just get a discount for knowing the guy at the counter.
Yeah, you know? You have a good chat with him. He's having, you know, you go in there 2:30 on a Friday. People haven't started really rolling in yet. He's ready to have a chat. You yarn with him. He's giving you $10 off a six pack.
Yeah, straight up. Oh, you want this? It goes off in 6 months. We can't sell it.
Oof.
Sounds good to me.
Actually, yeah, you got to go in and ask what he recommends, and he's going to recommend you the wildest shit you've ever seen in your life, or he's going to recommend you Bundy. And you pick one of those two options, he's giving you a discount.
Woo.
No in between. Liquorland.
I don't know why. I just hate Liquorland. I think it's like the logo, really. Like, I don't like that it just looks like a bad McDonald's logo, kind of.
Yeah, I don't like that it gives me the idea that potentially there could be a theme park related around liquor, and that doesn't exist. In fact, it's just a disappointing storefront.
Yeah, I think for that alone, C tier. I actually prefer it to BWS because it tends to be cheaper, but I don't like going there. I don't like deciding to go there. I don't like realizing that it's my only option.
It's, you know, when someone's like, you're like, oh, you go into someone's house and you got a Bottle-O nearby. Again, not the brand Bottle-O. You got a liquor shop nearby. And someone's like, yeah, I got a Liquorland. You're like, you got any others nearby?
Yeah.
You got a Bottle-O nearby, perhaps? So we're going low C, or I'd go high D, maybe.
Yeah, look, yeah, high D.
High D, okay. Celebrations?
No,
I'm not a fan.
Good wine selection, but the only one I've really been to was it was in like the sort of northern suburbs of Sydney, and
that's right.
Hosses did not like the manager there. He was a bit of a knob.
Yeah, I feel like it's a more upscale liquor shop.
It kind of reminds me that I'm not affluent.
Yes, which I don't want in my
No.
Liquor shop experience.
I'm trying to relax.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. I'm going, we're going.
Get a couple under the belt, you know, just chill out, not be reminded of my borderline poverty, you know?
Exactly. I'm trying to pick up a 2.5-liter little fat lamb and not be judged. And yet, here I am, guys looking at me, oh, you drink that shit?
Yeah, straight. Why do you sell it then? Shut
yeah,
up.
Yeah, yeah. I'm giving you money, aren't I?
God.
So we're going D tier, low C. What are we feeling?
I think C tier purely because of the selection. They sometimes have some good imports.
You know? I'd agree. And Star...
as a consumer, I'm a slave to choice.
Yes, of course. Now, Star Group, I've never heard of. I don't know if you... Okay, immediate D tier. Brand recognition, low.
Yeah, bad. Terrible.
Cringe. Vintage Cellars. I'm going to go out on a limb here. My local now is the Vintage Cellars. Bit pricey, but their member offers... Ah, hachi machi. Okay. I've never had a better member offer in my damn life.
Damn, that's crazy. I mean, I used to go to the Vintage Cellars in Newtown quite a bit when I still lived in Sydney. Not bad. Very, very close walking distance from Camperdown Park.
Yep.
Time.
Yep. I would say an A tier just under Dan Murphy's.
Yeah.
It's sure. Better than a BWS, no question.
Yeah, no question.
Except for the time at a Vintage Cellars, I got carded. And aggressively carded on New Year's Eve. Aside from
guessing that was before you shaved your head.
Yeah, but I was also still covered in tattoos. Last one, Thirsty Camel. I think I've shopped at the Thirsty Camel once in my life, but goddamn, I love the marketing.
I have never heard of this.
I think it's very regional. Regional okay. Australia.
Where did you... see this?
Great question. I don't know. I don't remember. I just know that I've seen it before, and I think I've been to one before.
Honestly, I would love to go to one.
Yeah, the branding alone, but that's all I remember about it.
Yeah, going off the fact that I want to go but have never had the option, maybe like a mid to low B.
I'd go higher than BWS B tier.
Okay, all right.
All right, we're locking it in. That's our first one. We got Aldi and the local bottle shop at an S tier. Dan Murphy's Vintage Cellars, A tier. Thirsty Camel BWS, B tier. First Choice Celebration, C tier. D tier, just all the trash. I'm going to just quickly update this. Bottle-O going to last in D tier because I cannot overstate how hard they fumbled the bag.
Yeah, honestly, they should be like high A tier.
Whoever is their marketing manager should be fired. They should hire another one and then fire them. People must pay.
Yeah, I just... Oh, God, it's such a good name for such a bad place. Like, I don't even know why it's so terrible.
I wish I had the answers.
Hard to qualify.
Honestly. I mean, look, they're losing to a liquor shop neither of us have ever heard of before. So,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.